And I'm indeed humbled to be treading in the footsteps of the illustrious Bert Bond. So I'll do my best to follow his footsteps. As you know, Aston Villa is very close to my heart, if you're in the colours. And I'm really delighted to be here today. But I'd like to pay particular tribute today to one man for whom Aston Villa has always been in his blood. Last year, head coach Dean Smith tragically lost his father, a lifelong Villa fan, and matchday steward, to COVID-19. His loss is just one of the many ways the pandemic has impacted the club over the last 12 months. And I want to offer my sincere condolences to Dean, pay tribute to his extraordinary contribution to the club since joining in 2018. I know your dad will be very proud. I am immensely proud to be associated with a club that does so much through the Aston Villa Foundation in support of the community, especially through the pandemic, as we've heard today. But I can't think of a crueler place than Villa Park to be vaccinated, unless you're a Birmingham City fan. A few years back, it gave me such pride to know that Villa were only one of two professional clubs in Europe to have a charitable shirt sponsor for whom the club raised funds. Villa's was Acorns Children's Hospice, and in 2017 I had the pleasure of meeting the club's number one fan, the courageous Louis Lewis, for whom Acorns Services are vital. So on to now, and I hope this amazing new facility helps to get Jack quite a fit for the next season. I'm heartened by this club's brighter future under such enthusiastic and supportive owners. And as the country's best armchair manager, I need to chat to Dean about the next match, as Christian alluded to. But first of all, I'm delighted to declare Aston Villa's High Performance Centre.
The black community and the Muslim community, we're difficult to attract. So our